Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I would like you to take a moment to hit that subscribe button and that notification bell to be notified whenever I drop a video. Okay, let's be honest, your girl hasn't been on YouTube in like forever, but I am back and I'm ready to relaunch my channel. And so I decided to start off with the 2018 BET Awards. There is so much hype about the award show and what took place, all the awkward moments with Jamie Foxx and the worst performances and the best performances and the best and worst dress. So let's get right into this video and talk about all this tea, okay? Okay, before we fully get into this video, you may hear some noise in the background. I have a 2-year-old son. Yes, I am on mommy duty, okay? So you may hear some sounds in the background. I'm trying to record this video along with him being awake. He doesn't want to take a nap. So I know a lot of you moms out there know how that goes. So I'm doing this video with my baby boy in the room. And yes, you're going to hear some noise in the background. Please excuse the noise, okay? So let's just jump right. Nicki Minaj performed her song Chung Lee and Rich Sex. And I'm just gonna let you know how I feel. Like, Nicki Minaj, I'm sorry, baby girl. Like, this year is just not your year. I think you need to take a break. I mean, let Cardi B do her thing. Cardi B is shining right now. She is on her A game. Let her have her year. Let her have her winning moment. And I just feel like you just need to fall back. The performance was subpar, baby girl. I'm sorry. I already don't like the song Chung Lee. And Rich Sex is okay. But I think she could have did way better. I never really seen Nicki Minaj's performances, but I just feel like this one was just tired. I feel like she's just running out of things and ideas of things to do. Like, she just needed to like scrap her whole team, get a whole new team of people, a whole new image, and just come better next year. Take a break. Let Cardi B have the floor. Let her be the queen for the year of 2018 and come back next year. I don't even think she should release her album. I noticed she's supposed to be releasing an album in the next month or so, but baby girl, put that back on the shelf. A great performance that I think went on at the award show was Meek Mill. He had a great message. I think his message got a little misconstrued or lost because people were having controversy or problems with him covering somebody with an American flag. The American flag is not supposed to touch the floor. Like, who cares at this point? Like, people are just going above and beyond just being conscious, and they're missing the whole point of the message. And I think he had a great performance. I love the idea and the concept of where he's trying to go with it. And I think it's what's needed in the music industry right now. I want to jump into Jamie Foxx and just his awkwardness the whole night. I don't know if something was wrong. The teleprompter, whoever was operating the teleprompter, things were just off. It seemed like nothing was rehearsed. Everything was just like, let's just freeball it. Okay, let's just run the show and let's just make things happen. Let's just fill in the blanks. And it just wasn't working. The awkward moment with him and Childish Gambino, him telling him to, you know, Childish Gambino to come up on the stage and trying to, you know, get the vibe of starting off This Is America song. It just wasn't working. The crowd wasn't really into it. But I don't know. It was just a weird moment. Just tell me what you think about that in the comments. A great performance that I actually really enjoyed was the artist named Her. I am just now getting on top of this girl and, you know, hearing about her music. I think she did a wonderful job, and her performance was great. She sounds exactly how she sounds on her records, and I think that's just phenomenal. I think she has really great, great potential, and I am looking forward to seeing more performances and hearing more music from this girl, okay? I want to get into the Anita Baker tribute. I thoroughly enjoyed the performances. Jamie Foxx started it off, was singing a little bit of snippets of her songs, and then it went into Marsha Ambrosia. Marsha Ambrosia, I love her voice. I love the way she sings most of the time. I just hate when she does that, like, I don't know, that rivet thing in her voice. I think that is horrible. I noticed like her signature style, or what she's trying to make her signature style, but I think she just needs to X that out and just sing, baby girl, sing. You know, you're a great singer, you're a great vocalist. I just hate when you do that extra oh, that extra thing in your voice, it just totally annoys me and throws everything off. My girl Lettucey, oh god, Lettucey is the greatest. She can sing, she can do all types of things with her voice. Absolutely love her. She sung very well and she gave a great performance, and I see that she actually sent some chills through Anita Baker's spine. Like, yes girl, you did it. Yolanda Adams, of course, another very well put together woman that can sing, and she just did the damn thing, okay? Anita Baker was feeling it, I was feeling it. I just love the choices that they did make to put these three women together and to give tribute to Anita Baker, and I think they just did a wonderful job. Well, that's it for you guys.